Hi, welcome to Design at Home. I'm Emily, an educator at Cooper Hewitt Smithsonian Design Museum. Today we're going to talk about textile designer Suzie Zuzek, look at examples of her beautiful intricate pattern designs, and learn how to design a repeating pattern on our own at home. Suzie Zuzek was an accomplished, prolific textile designer well known for her colorful, beautiful pattern designs, which are most recognizable in the form of fashion sold by Lilly Pulitzer from 1962 to 1985. Zuzek studied textile design and illustration at Pratt Institute in Brooklyn, New York, graduating at the top of her class, and worked for 3 years designing fabrics in New York before moving to Key West, Florida. In Key West, she began working at Key West Handprint Fabrics, a silkscreen printing company. The company quickly attracted its first major client in Lilly Pulitzer, who was enchanted by the Zuzek designs she discovered there, and began buying textiles there for her shift dresses and other styles. Zuzek's pattern designs take inspiration from nature, as well as art and other visual sources. Her subjects included abundant florals, underwater scenes with fish and shells, and stylized depictions of animals from near and far. She understood that her designs would be viewed from a distance as an overall pattern, as well as enjoyed up close, and more details are revealed as you look closer. Zuzek's imaginative prints made Lilly Pulitzer's simple sportswear styles unique and immediately recognizable. Pulitzer's fashions, featuring Zuzek's prints, were worn by such notable people as First Lady Jacqueline Kennedy. Keeping in mind Zuzek's wonderful patterns, let's jump in now to our design challenge. Our challenge today is to design a repeating pattern that is inspired by nature. You may find inspiration in your home, looking at your houseplants or your pet, or even into your fruit or vegetable drawer. You can also look outside your window to see if you find inspiration there, or think about a part of nature that means a lot to you. Let's start by gathering our materials. To design today, we will need a piece of paper, a pen or pencil, and if you'd like to add color, you can find something that will help you to do this. I'm using watercolor paints, which is a tool that Suzie Zuzek also used in her designs. And finally, in order to make your repeating pattern, you will need tape and scissors. Okay. Now we're ready to begin. The steps to creating a repeating pattern are up on the screen. I'm going to go through this with you step by step. To get started, grab your piece of paper, pen, or pencil to draw with, and an object of inspiration if you have one. I used a lemon. Take as much time as you need to draw your initial pattern. Don't worry about making your pattern repeat. Our later steps will create a repeat from what you draw. When your initial drawing is done, you can add color. I'm using paint, but you can also use markers, crayons, pastels, or colored pencils. Keep adding color until your drawing is complete. Using a pair of scissors, cut your drawing in half lengthwise. For the most precise cut, you can first use a ruler to find and mark the halfway point. Switch the two sides so that the right side is now on the left. Using tape, attach the two pieces like this. Be sure to tape the back, not the front, of your design. Now make another cut, cutting the paper in half widthwise. Again, switch the pieces so the piece that was on the right is now on the left. Tape the two pieces together in this new configuration. Be sure to tape on the back. After putting these pieces together, you'll likely have an empty space in the center of your page. Fill this in now with drawings similar to your initial design. Don't forget to add color here as well. When you've finished, you have the final product. As we're all designing our own patterns, your product will look different from mine. Here are a few other examples of pattern designs up on the screen. We should now all have our finished pattern design. Now that we've finished this design and we've created a repeating pattern, this can be used to print on something like fabric, even a t-shirt or a tote bag, for example. We would love to see what you've designed if you or an adult would like to share it with us on social media. To share what you've designed, please use the hashtag SmithsonianEDU. Thank you so much for tuning in. We hope that you'll also keep your eye out for the upcoming exhibition at Cooper Hewitt featuring Suzie Zuzek and her pattern designs. For more ways to experience design at home, head over to our website or check out our page on the Smithsonian Learning Lab. Thank you, and we'll see you next time. Bye.